We're discussing a super common video editing problem: removing audio from your video footage. Maybe you've got annoying background noise, unwanted music, or just want a silent clip for a specific effect. Whatever your reason, I'm going to show you how to do it quickly and easily. In this video, I will show you how to remove audio from a video on an iPhone, Android device, Windows PC, or laptop. And in the final part, we will discuss and show you how to delete audio from a file with a Mac. Before we start, please remember to like the video and share it. Thank you a lot. How to remove audio from video on iPhone. This is done with a pre-installed app on your iPhone. The app is called iMovie. If you don't have iMovie installed, go to the App Store, search for iMovie, and download it. I will do so in the next few seconds. After iMovie is installed, open it. Tap on Continue. On this screen, select Movie. This will start a new project. Choose the video you want to mute from your library and tap Create Movie at the bottom of the screen. Tap on the video timeline to select it. The timeline is this zone. You can move in the timeline at whatever zone you want. On the bottom, you will have a text called Detach. This will make that the video will be splitted into two zones in the timeline. One will be the video, and one will be the audio. You see that the bottom part is the audio. Let's see for now how we can just remove a part of the audio from the video. Navigate to the timeline to the beginning of the part you want to delete. When you get there, you will see an option called Split on the bottom. Tap it. You see now that the timeline is broken. Now go to the end of the part you want to delete. You will see the same split option. Tap it. You see now that the part we want to delete is splitted. Tap on that zone. Now that zone is selected. From the bottom, tap Delete. You see that zone is now gone. This will remove the audio on that part of the video. Let's see for now how we can just remove the full audio from the video. I will revert the changes I previously made. We will do the same. Tap on the video timeline to select it. At the bottom, you will see a text called Detach. This will make that the video will be splitted into two zones in the timeline. One will be the video, and one will be the audio. Tap on the bottom timeline. Now tap on the Delete button. The audio has been removed. We only need to export the file now. Tap on the Done from the top. Now tap on the Share button. Tap on Save or Share Video. You can share the video if you want on what app you want, or just scroll down and tap Save to Files. Select where you want to save the file, and tap Save. Your new file without audio will be available where you saved it. You've successfully removed audio from your video on your iPhone using iMovie. How to remove audio from video on Android. In this video, I will show you how you can mute a video with the Photos app on your Android device. Also, I will show you how you can edit the video file with a more advanced video editor. Let's see how you can use the Photos app on your device. Unlock your Android device and open the Gallery app, or maybe the Camera app. Browse through your photos and videos to find the video you want to mute. Tap on it to open. At the bottom of the screen, tap on the Edit icon. It looks like three horizontal lines with sliders. In the video editing screen, tap the sound icon, a speaker symbol, at the bottom left. This will mute the audio in your video. After muting the audio, tap the muted video at the bottom right to save your changes in your Google Photos library. But what if need only a part of the audio to be removed? In this case, you need to edit the video file with more sophisticated software. You can use apps like InShot, KineMaster, PowerDirector, Viva Video, and Filmora Go. You can explore these apps to find the one that best suits your needs. For this video, we will use InShot. If you don't have InShot installed, go to the Google Play Store, search for InShot, and download it. I will do this now. Launch the InShot app from your home screen or Google Play Store. Tap on Video and select the video you want to mute from your gallery. Tap on the video timeline to select it. Then tap on the volume icon, a speaker symbol, and drag the volume slider all the way to the left to mute the audio. If you want to edit the video, you can just tap on Extract Audio. Now you will see the audio and the video on the timeline. You can now delete this full new audio, or just split the audio zone and then delete only the part you want to. After you have made the changes, you will need to export the file and save the file. Tap the checkmark icon to confirm the changes. Then tap Save at the top right and choose the resolution you prefer. The video will be saved to your gallery without audio. You've successfully removed audio from your video on your Android device using different methods. Whether you prefer using Google Photos, InShot, Adobe Premiere Rush, or KineMaster, muting a video is quick and easy. How to remove audio from video on Windows? We will use two methods to remove audio from a video file: a software called VLC and a software that is created by Microsoft called Microsoft Clipchamp. Now let's see how to remove audio from video on Windows using VLC. VLC is a versatile, free tool that makes this process simple and quick, so you don't have to pay anything for using this tool. If you don't already have VLC Media Player installed on your computer, we need to go to the official VLC website. Open the browser on your Windows device. On the address bar, write VLC download. The official site for VLC is called VideoLAN. Click on the first result. Click on Download VLC and follow the on-screen instructions to install the software. Open the file you just downloaded. Click Yes. Select the language of the app. I will use English and click OK. Click Next until you reach the final step. Click Install. After the installation is complete, launch VLC from your Start menu or desktop shortcut. Click on Media in the top menu, then select Convert Save. In the new window, click Add to select the video file you want to mute, then click Convert Save at the bottom. In the Convert window, click on the wrench icon next to the Profile dropdown to open the Profile Edition window. Go to the Audio Codec tab and uncheck the audio box if it's checked. Write a profile name and click Create. I will choose the profile No Audio. Now select No Audio on the profile you just created. In the Convert window, select the destination folder and file name for the new video file. Click Start to begin the conversion. VLC will create a new video file without audio. It will take a bit of time depending on the power of your PC to create the file. This is how you remove audio from a video in Windows with VLC. Now let's see how to remove audio from video on Windows using Microsoft Clipchamp. If you don't already have Clipchamp installed on your computer, go to the Microsoft Store and search for Clipchamp. Click on Get to download and install the software. Usually, this software should be pre-installed on any Windows 11 laptop or PC. Go to the file that you want to remove the audio, or you can launch Clipchamp from your Start menu or desktop shortcut and create a new project. I will just open the file with Clipchamp. You see there is a file that is now preparing. If you do not see this, you can click on the Import Media. Browse to find the video file you want to mute, select it, and click Open. The video will be added to your media library. Wait until the file is prepared. Drag the imported video from the media library to the timeline at the bottom of the screen. Right-click on the video clip in the timeline to select it. This will bring up the editing options for the video. From the menu that appears, go with the mouse over audio. You will have the option to detach the audio file and mute the audio. If you want to simply mute the entire video, just click on mute. Before I will continue the video, let me do one more follow-up about this option. When I was editing the video, I remembered that I did not show you how to delete only a part of the audio file with Clipchamp. Let me show you this option as well, and then we will continue with the first record. So we have a new project with the audio file not removed. We will right-click on the timeline. On the menu that pops up, we will go with the mouse over audio and select detach. Wait until the audio file is detached. You see on the top right that the audio is prepared. It can take a bit of time depending on the site of the video and the speed of your laptop or PC. You see now the audio has appeared in the timeline. Go over the audio timeline with the mouse and right-click the start of the part you want to delete. Click split from the menu. Now go to the end of the audio timeline and right-click. Select again split. You see now you have three fragments of the audio. Right-click on the fragment you want to delete. From the menu, select delete. Now you have deleted only a part of the audio. You can follow from now on the next part of the video as it is the same. Now let's get back to the original record. Once you've muted the audio, click on the export button in the top right corner of the screen. Choose the resolution you want for your output video. Clipchamp will process the video and prepare it for export. Once the export is complete, you will be prompted to save the video. Choose a location on your computer to save the muted video file and click Save. And that's it. You've successfully removed audio from your video using Microsoft Clipchamp on your Windows PC. How to remove audio from video on Mac. For this task, we will use iMovie on your Mac. This is a pre-installed app on your device, so you should not have any issues with it. If you removed it from your device, you can easily reinstall it. Open iMovie from your Applications folder or by searching for it in Spotlight. It seems that I do not have it anymore on my Mac, as I have not used it much, so I will have to install it. Click on the App Store. Search for iMovie and click Get or the cloud icon when you find the app. Now the app is installed. Let's open it. Click Continue. Click on Create New and select Movie from the options. Click on the Import Media button. Browse to find the video you want to mute and import it into your project. Allow iMovie to access your files. When the file is imported, just double-click it or drag the imported video from the media library to the timeline at the bottom of the screen. Click on the video clip in the timeline to select it. Now right-click the video clip timeline. From the menu that pops up, select Attach Audio. You will see two files now on the timeline. One is the audio and one is the video file. Let's see for now how we can remove only a part of the audio from the file. Let's say maybe we want to send the file, but we want to remove something that we said. When you go with the mouse pointer, you see a line. Go with the mouse over the audio timeline to the start of the selection you want to delete. Right-click on that zone. A new menu will appear. Click on Split. Now go to the end of the part you want to delete and do the same. You will see now that you have a part of the audio file that is fragmented. Right-click on the part you want to delete. Now from the menu that appears, select Delete. You have removed now a part of the audio, keeping the rest of the audio untouched. But what if you want to remove the full audio of the file? I will just restore the file until we did the split. Now we have the full audio file. Right-click on the audio timeline. Select the delete option and the file is now mute. After we have done all the changes, click on the share button from the top right. Select export file. Choose your export settings and click next. Name your file, choose a save location, and click Save. The video will be saved without audio. And that's it. You've successfully removed audio from your video on your Mac. If you found this video helpful, please consider leaving a like and subscribe to my channel for more tech tips and tricks. As always, if you have any questions or requests for future videos, drop them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.